everyone, I am Maria Felipe and I am your pause instructor. I am so grateful and thankful. I am so excited to go over this book with you today. Pause for Your Helpful Self. Kids can pause and parents too and teachers too. The whole world can pause. And my son, when he gets really excited, he goes like this. He goes like this. I am so excited. And that's exactly how I feel right now. So let's get started. Hi, my pause friends. I am so, how do I say it? Excited. We're gonna start with part one, get to know your helpful self. Get to know your helpful self. And this is really, really cool because you can pause for your helpful self, always your true self. So your helpful self is your true self. So how can we connect to our true self? How can we connect to our helpful self? So this wheel here is very, very helpful. So you can touch any word to help you connect with your helpful self. You want me to show you how? Yes? Can I hear you? Good. So let's go ahead and touch. I'm gonna say out loud, loving, loving. And peaceful, peaceful. These words, and when you touch each and every word, you can go ahead and that helps you connect with your helpful self. You can press on one word, you can say two words, three words, whatever feels good for you. Your helpful self will guide you. And this beautiful, you see this beautiful girl here in that beautiful position, very, very meditative, very calm. My helpful self points me in a helpful direction. My helpful self is the love in me. So your helpful self is the love in you and it points you to the loving direction, to the direction of gentleness, of feeling better, of being peaceful, feeling peaceful. And here we have, oh my goodness, here we have Happy the dog. So Happy the dog is thinking, my helpful self points me in the helpful direction. My helpful self is the love in me, which is what the little girl was saying. So Happy's thinking about that. And then Happy gets so inspired. And this is what Happy says. He says, yes, the love in me is my helpful self. Why don't you guys say it out loud? Go ahead. Ready? One, two, three. Yes, the love in me is my helpful self. And guess what, everyone? You have a helpful self too. Everybody together. You have a helpful self too. All right, let's go ahead to part two. Hi friends, we're on part two. Pausing for my helpful self can help me. Here we're gonna see the different ways that pausing can be helpful. One, when you feel upset or mad, lonely or sad, when you need an answer with absolutely anything, your helpful self can help you. Also, when you wake up in the morning and when you go to bed, also you can pause before you say anything that can't be unsaid. When you're standing in line and waiting your turn, you see, at the ice cream truck, or with all the new things I can learn. There's also so many other ways that the helpful self can help you. One is when I'm at school and I meet someone new with the things I say and do. When doing my homework and studies, with how to get along with family and buddies, when someone is being a bully and being unkind, with all the thoughts that are in my mind. You can understand and learn new things I have not yet done. Your helpful self helps with that. Maybe something new that you haven't done before, your helpful self can help you feel more confident in doing something new. And it could also help with all things under the sun. And look at here, look at Happy Dog. Happy Dog is saying, practice pausing for your helpful self. Sometimes your helpful self may lead you to talk with parents, teachers, counselors about your feelings and what's on your mind. And now we're getting to the great, amazing part, the helpful self practice. Let's check it out.
We're on part three. And here's Happy Dog with us again. He's gonna take us through how to do the pause for help, the helpful self practice, which are four steps.
The first step is pause. Second step is step back. Third step is step aside. And the last and final step is let my helpful self guide. So we're going to be going through that right now. Are you ready? Let's start. Hi, my friends. So here we have the very first step, which you've already heard a little bit about, right? It's the pause. Can we all say it together? One, two, three, pause. So what is the pause? Let's get to know the pause a little bit better. I can practice pausing and to choose to slow down. So pausing is slowing down, and that can help you feel calm and it can help you feel safe. Now let's see what, wait a second. Happy the dog wants to say something. Let's see what Happy the dog is saying. So Happy the dog is saying, to pause is to choose a moment of quiet inner calm. Doggy says, I can take as long as I need to rest my mind. There's no need to hurry. Woof, woof. That's what Doggy says. And look at this helpful button here. The pause colorful button. Do you see it? Isn't it wonderful? Well, you can use the pause button now. Press the button to start your pause. Your helpful self is the pause. So that's what it is, guys. You see, we're trying to figure it out. Pause is slowing down. And when you slow down, you're able to connect to your helpful self, which is actually the pause. Want to start? Let's go ahead and press the button. Ding! Now, do you want to have a better day? Don't we all want to have better days? When we go to school, when we go to the park, when we're with our families, when we're with our teachers, don't we want to have better days? Well, if you practice the pause, you're going to have a better day. And when can you practice the pause? Well, look at all these fun ways you can practice the pause. You can practice it when you're riding the school bus, playing guitar, basketball. My little guy's in peewee basketball right now. And it's very helpful to pause because it could get very overwhelming with the competition and everything, right? Look, when you're in school, you can pause. When you're learning, when you're skateboarding, there's so many different ways to pause. And you can use it in any scenario in your life. Now, we're going to learn, now that we know the pause and where we could use it, now we can see how we can do the second step, which is step back. Hi, everyone. We're on step two, step back. Doggy's saying, after I pause, I get out of my own way by choosing to clear my mind of what I am thinking now. This will make room for helpful thoughts from my helpful self. Now, this is really important here because it says, I can practice pausing and choose to take a deep breath. I can choose to get out of my own way. One of the best ways to do this, guys, to step back is actually to breathe. Do you want to learn how to do a very nice, different breathing exercise that we usually don't do every day to be very mindful of our breathing? Okay, this is how we practice it. So we inhale by inhaling through our nose. Maybe you want to put your hand on your nose so you could inhale and exhale. Hand on your nose, inhale, exhale through the mouth. So that helps to coordinate the breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth. And look at these guys, they're trying it here. And look, he's thinking, this helps me see things differently. So just the breath, inhaling, is helping him see things differently. And she is thinking, oh, now I feel much better. Now she feels much better after that exhale. Now let's go to the next step. The next step is step aside. Hey guys, we are in step number tres. Step three, step aside. Let's see how that one works. So I can practice pausing and choose to be still and listen to my helpful self. So it's a stepping aside so that we can listen to our helpful self. And this is a really nice practice that you can do. You can think, right now, I want help with dot, dot, dot. So think of something that you would want to have help with. And Doggy is also helping you. Happy Dog is helping you understand this a little bit better. And Doggy says, once I have made room in my mind, I choose what I want help with. Then I ask my helpful self, what will be truly helpful right now? So Happy Dog says, you first want to see what you need help with, and then you want to ask your helpful self what will be truly helpful right now. And then doggy says, my helpful self can point me in the right direction. And let's not forget the wheel. You can always remember the wheel and the words, so that way you can go ahead and connect to your helpful self. Remember, that helps you to pause. And then in the second step, when you're going to step aside, you can use the wheel and say the words so that you can connect to your helpful self. And that means that you are stepping aside, because you're not just taking an action right away. You're not being impulsive. You're pausing and stepping aside. You go ahead and you see the pinwheel here, and you touch the word, and you can say safe. Or you can go ahead and say happy, right? Let's go see how this guy over here that's playing soccer deals with this second step and how he does this second step. So the scenario is they're playing soccer, correct? You see all these kids playing soccer. And then this kid is saying out loud, can I play? And you see that he seems like he's sad or he's feeling uncomfortable. And then you have this guy here that he is thinking, and he's practicing stepping aside, right? Because he's thinking, how can I include the new guy? I can pause for the helpful thing to say and do. So he's pausing right now. He's pausing, and at the same time, by that pause, he's going into the second step, which is stepping aside, because he's asking for help, right? And then you see that he's thinking right away of the wheel, and he's thinking of the word that will be helpful so that he can help this guy at this moment. Isn't that incredible? So that is how we step aside, my friends. Now, hi, my friends, we're on step 4, let my helpful self guide. And here Happy Dog says, now that I have asked and listened to what will be truly helpful now, I can choose to follow my helpful self, who leads me to be safe, kind, calm, and helpful. So you can go ahead and in your book, you get Happy Dog and you could lead it down the path of safety, of calm. You can also have other paths such as leading to kindness, to being truly helpful, and much, much more. Because your helpful self is always gonna guide you to the path of happiness, peace, and joy. Hey, my beautiful friends, we are on step number 4. Pausing for my helpful self can help make everyday life better. Everyday life better. We're gonna go ahead here and look at the wheel again. I can pause for my helpful self, my true self. And remember that this wheel helps us pause for our helpful self. So you can go ahead and wise, you can go ahead and worthy, peaceful, helpful, kind, wise. And as you can see here, look at the family, how they're thinking about the wheel and they're thinking about their word and connecting to their helpful self. And she says, the girl's saying, my helpful self points me in a helpful direction. My helpful self is the love in me, right? We had discussed that earlier. Our helpful self is the love in us. Then the doggy is also, he's thinking, oh, right. So he feels it. He agrees. And the mother says, yes, it's true. The love in me is my helpful self. So the love in us is our helpful self. We can also practice this at school. So you see here, all the kids are at school. And here's the teacher. And the teacher says, it's true. I have a helpful self that can help me with my teaching. She's thinking this, right? And then you see here how all the kids are thinking. So one kid is thinking, yes, I do have a helpful self. And this kid over here, he's like me when I was in school. He says, oh, when's the bell going to ring? I was a little impatient. I wish I had this book when I was a little girl in school. It says here, I can ask questions, right? She's thinking here. And then he's thinking, I can get help. The girl's thinking, gee, I'm so tired, right? So these are all thoughts. So we all have thoughts. And we can, connecting to our true self, we can start to have thoughts that are very, very helpful. Now it says here, you can practice pausing for your helpful self. Who has a helpful self? Everyone has a helpful self. So everyone has a helpful self. How else can you practice this? At school, right? We saw that. Now at play. So you see all, this is scenario here at play. This person is thinking, why am I doing this, right? Because she is taking away this person's teddy bear, right? Girl's teddy bear, and she's thinking, why am I doing this? She's thinking about it because she thought about the pinwheel. She was thinking about her words. She's connecting to her helpful self. So she's thinking, why is she doing this? This doesn't feel right, right? And then, ouch, stop. Please give it back, right? So the girl is very sad. Then there's a girl over here that she says, yikes, bullying. What can I say and do that is safe and helpful? So she's also connecting to her helpful self at play. And she's thinking, wow, what can I say? So going back to that, what can I say? What can I do? How can I be most helpful here? Is how this whole scenario is going to be a positive, and it's going to end in a positive. You can also do the help, you practice helpful self and connecting to your helpful self and pausing, doing chores. So she is cleaning. And then you see Happy Dog says, woof, we can practice pausing while doing chores, right? And then she's thinking, I'm grateful I can help my mom, right? And the boy says, I like helping at home. And she's saying, being helpful is so calming. It's fun to help, right? So you can pause and do the pause steps while you are doing chores. At the store. So this is interesting here with all the family at the grocery store. So you have, she says, I don't want to shop. And this one's saying, I want to go home. And the baby is almost crying here. Well, it is crying. And then the boy says, oh, wow, how can I help? Right? Because he's, and then now mom is thinking, oh, I need help. Okay, helpful self, what can I say and do that is loving and helpful for me and my kids right now? So parents can pause too. You can also pause on adventures. So this is son and father, and son is thinking, oh yeah, I can have fun and tell my dad what's on my mind. And then dad is thinking, it's so fun being with my son. Pausing for my helpful self really helps to bring us together. And you can also pause wherever you are. And here are father, daughter, and son. And son is saying, I can practice pausing and choose to slow down. I can feel safe and calm. And she says, I can pause for help too. And daddy's thinking, I'm so happy I'm practicing pausing for my helpful self. It really helps me hear and listen to my children. You can pause whatever you are doing, right? So this is grandma. Grandma, and it looks like Happy Dog is there too. And Happy Dog is thinking, that looks good to me. And he's looking at the chicken. And then grandma says, oh no, dinner's ruined. What am I doing? What am I going to do now? Right? So then here's a boy, and he's a smart little boy, and he has the book, right? This book, kids can pause and parents too. He comes up to grandma and says, grandma, we can practice pause for your helpful self to see what will be helpful to do right now. So grandma can see it differently. And you see, doggy is already seeing it differently because he thinks even though it's burnt, it looks good to him. And here we're practicing at school. So you see today's subject is help with asking for help, paying attention and listening, being a kind and peaceful classmate. So that's today's subject. And the kid is saying, hey, the pause for your helpful self practice can help with all of these. And he has the book. And then the teacher says, I could use a practice myself. Class, we could really come up with some great ideas by using the helpful self practice for these subjects. And who's ready to begin? Your helpful self. Practice, practice, practice. And she's thinking, awesome, I'm getting to know my helpful self. And then Happy Dog here is thinking, all right, my helpful self is my true self, and now I'm truly happy. Whomever you're with, pause for your helpful self. Who always wants you to be safe? Who is always kind and always loving you? And here's what Happy has to say. Happy Dog, important, remember to also listen to your parents and teachers about being safe. Hi friends, it was a joy to go over this book with you. Pause for your helpful self. Kids can pause, and parents too, teachers too, anyone can pause. And we went over these amazing steps: pause, step back, step aside, and let my helpful self guide. It was truly an honor and a joy. Happy Dog, thank you so much for guiding me, for helping me. I love the amazing wheel that we have over here that reminds us of our helpful self and its characteristics. We are so grateful. Let's go ahead and close it out with, let's turn this and spin the wheel. My helpful self is worthy. My helpful self is worthy, and that helps me connect to my helpful self. Have a beautiful day. Also, don't forget to check out the website pauseforyourhelpfulself.org for more information and more resources. Till next time.